Guys, this is a 2016 question paper for BCom for 14 marks. Just if you read out, you can understand. And with the help of this, he is asked us to prepare reconciliation statement and also ascertain profit as per financial books, he is asked. And we will try to solve this question. And please write this question in a book so that it will be helpful for you in understanding when I am solving it on the board. Guys, quickly we read this question, 2016 question paper. From the following details, you are required to prepare a reconciliation statement and also ascertain profit as per financial accounting. See guys, we have certain particulars, cash book items and financial books items are there. And we have to look at the format. According to the format, I will show you how to solve this question. Okay, he is given profit as per cost accounting records as 3,85,000. But he is not given profit as per financial books. He is given cost book profit, but not financial book profits. Now, what we need to do? First, we write profit as per cost books. Right? So, profit as per cost books. Okay? C books means cost books he is given. How much he is given is 3,85,000 rupees is given. Now we'll read one after one and we'll try to look at the format also, and looking at the format we will try to solve it. Okay. First item is works overhead. See, works overhead is nothing but factory overheads or factory expenses. See, the factory expenses in cost books is given 68,500. But cost book, factory overheads as per financial books is given 72,000. What is the difference amount is 72,000 minus 68,500. The difference is 3,500 rupees. If you look at cost books, the expenses, factory expenses is recorded less. See, under absorption overheads in cost accounting. Means if you record any expenses less, under expenses, under charged, under absorption in cost accounting, we need to minus it here. So what I will do is I will add certain items here, I will deduct certain items here so that it becomes easy for us. First one is works overhead. Under recorded. So it is 70,000 minus 68,500. So 3,500 rupees is recorded less in cost accounting. So any expenses recorded less in cost accounting, we will go to deduct. If the same expenses would have recorded more, we would have added. Okay. Next is administration overhead is 92,750. But in financial accounting, it is given 1,02,650. Again, in cost accounting, administration overhead is recorded less. How much it is recorded less is 1,02,650 minus 92,750. You get 99,900. So second point is administration overhead. Okay. Under recorded. How much it is under recorded is 9,900. Difference amount we need to add. Now second, third point is over. Next is selling overheads is recorded 45,600 in cost books, but the same selling overheads is taken financial books as 38,500. In this case, cost accounting overheads are recorded more. So now over means what? They have recorded more in cost accounting. Therefore, selling overheads overcharged in cost accounting. What is the difference amount is? The difference amount is 45,600 minus 38,500. 7,100 rupees is recorded more in cost accounting. So therefore, we are adding. Next is depreciation. See, if you look at the depreciation, there is no depreciation charged in cost accounting, but depreciation is charged in financial accounting as 62,850 rupees. See, what happens if you don't show any expenses in cost accounting? See, if this is an expenses, this is only for your information, and if this is incomes, what will be the effect of profit? Okay, if expenses are more, your profit will be less. Right? If your expenses are less, your profit will be more. Right? Now, in this case, depreciation is an expenses. Depreciation is an expenses. If there is no depreciation at all, or less depreciation, no depreciation is charged, your profit will be showing more. So therefore, we will deduct it here. Because if profit is showing more, we minus it. If profit is showing less, we add it. Here, depreciation is not charged in cost accounting because of expenses not taken. Because of expenses not taken, your profit is showing more. So therefore, we have to add it. So depreciation charged only in FA or not charged in CA also, you can write 62,850 rupees. Next point is stores adjustment credit. I told you when I was explaining you, when I was explaining the format, I told you credit means incomes, debit means expenses, because all incomes are credit. All incomes and gains are credit, all debits are expenses and losses. Here, there is no income recorded in the cost books. It is a nature, right? By nature, cost accounting books will not record any incomes at all. If there is no income, see, financial incomes not recorded. If incomes are not recorded in cost accounting, costing profit will be showing less. See, here, in case of incomes, if more incomes, more incomes, more profit. If profit is showing more, we have to minus. If less income, less profit, and we need to add it. Here, less profit, less income, less profit, we need to add it here. Second one is stores adjustment credit. Stores adjustment credit. Amount is 7,500 rupees. Next is value of opening stock. See, here we have to understand one thing clearly. Opening stock is valued in cost accounting as 86,400. In financial, it is recorded 75. Means in cost accounting, it is recorded more. Means overvaluation of opening stock. So, overvaluation of opening stock. What is the difference value is? Difference value is 11,400 rupees. Okay. Next is value of closing stock. Here, value of closing stock is cost accounting is 94,800. In financial, 86,400. Definitely, closing stock is overvalued. Overvaluation of closing stock. Undervaluation of closing stock should be added. Overvaluation of closing stock should be deducted. So therefore, overvaluation of closing stock in CA. How much it is? Is 8,400 rupees. Now, we are done with this also. Reserve for bad debts. See, there is no expenses. I told you, when I was explaining you, expenses charged only in financial accounting. Say reserve for bad debts, reserve for taxation, all these are the expenses we show only in financial accounting. So therefore, we deduct it here, reserve for bad debts amount is 16,050 rupees. And next, interest on bank deposit received is an income, right? Interest received. So any income which not recorded in CA. So in CA no incomes are recorded, so we write it here as interest on bank deposits 16,750. Next point is loss on sale of machinery. See, any expenses charged only in FA. There is no loss on sale of machineries, or any sale of machinery losses will not be recorded in cost books, but which will be charged, which will be taken in the financial accounting only. So loss on sale of machinery 15,000 rupees to be deducted here on machinery. Okay, next is tax provision. I told you, even provision, how reserve for bad debts you take it here, same thing, taxation provision also will be taken here, 42,750. Last point, interest on bank loan paid. See, when you borrow loan from bank and you pay the interest, such interest is not taken in the cost accounting. Any expenses which is charged only in FA but not in CA should be deducted. So therefore, interest on loan paid amount is 18,250 should be deducted. That's all. See, we have done with the 2016 question paper, which carries 14 marks. Now what we need to do is, we have to add all the items, take it in the outer column. So 5, 11, 15, 16, 1 carries, 7, 8, 15, 22, and 42,650. Add these two items, add. So 650, 7, 12, 4 lakh 27, 650. And if you add all the less items, 5, 10, 15, 20, 20, 2 carries, 4, 11, 15, 23, 42, 47, 4, 12, 14, 19, 25, 33, 35, 35, 35, 38, 47, 4 carries, 5, 6, 10, 11, 11 plus 6, 17. So 1,77,700, we have to deduct it. If you deduct, how much you get is 9, 16 minus is 9, 11 minus 7 is 4, 3 minus 1 is 2. So 2,49,950, this is the profit as per financial account. Guys, got it? So simple question, very simple question, and we have taken here 2,49,950. So add items, all of you understood. This is a 14 marks question, appeared in the examination 2016.